Your location has changed a lot over the years. There was a time when a lot of people probably were hesitant to go and park their cars to come into Army and Navy.
You're talking about the flagship store on Yaston. We are certainly, we've been through the whole gamut, as you know. You know, during the days of the Wood Squad and during the days of the Picton murders, I mean, you couldn't put the news on without hearing, worst postal code in the world is our, you know, our postal code. And it was tough times. It really was. And I'm proud now when I walk out of the office on Cordova Street and you see so much life and so much youth and vitality. And yet, what I'm most proud about is I still see my welfare recipients and my fixed income supporters that have lived there and have pride of ownership. They're not down there to scare anybody to do anything. That's their home. So that word gentrification, you know, is a bad word because it means that we're just, you know, displacing so many people that that's been their home for all their life. So I'm very proud when I walk down the street and they say, well, you know, they know me by name and they say, you know, thank you for being here. You know, I think
you've been supportive of the neighborhood.
I love the neighborhood. I feel like it's my neighborhood. I grew up there. I was 6 years old, and I used to feed the birds in Pigeon Park, and it is really my home. So I'm as comfortable there as I am on the west side. And it's an unfortunate thing that still to this day, you know, people have a conception about that you can't park your car or, you know, you can't park your car in Oak Ridge either these days. So, you know, I don't know. I mean, I take it personally when they go, oh, no.
Well, that's because you got a Bentley.
No, I didn't mean me. I'm just saying that, anyway, as we all know in Vancouver, that the our Gastown area is becoming Soho of Vancouver. It was just voted, I think, the fourth top neighborhood in the world.
Well, it's changing dramatically. And there are a lot of people who don't like that.
But as I say, I can see that there are people that don't, but really, if it didn't have an infusion of youth and vitality and you know, then the area wasn't going to go anywhere. So I think, excuse me, that the key is to have everybody mixed together. And I think they're doing a good job of it.
But is it good for your business as it changes?
Yes. I'm experiencing a growth right now in the downtown Eastside store, which is nice to see. I think, you know, after all these years of not closing it up when everybody said, what are you doing down there? Walk away. Leave it. You know, and I just...
Were people saying that to you?
Oh, for sure. Yeah. Yeah.
But you weren't buying it?
No. As I just said, it's like another home to me. And, you know, my grandfather and my family, they're still in there. And I'm proud of the fact that we're still there, 93 years after Grappa started it.
And you're going to stick with it?
The next generation is already in it, fourth generation of Cohens.
The Chief Executives, broadcasting live from the SFU Beedie School of Business on CKNW.